Hello, my name is Larry, and welcome to my YouTube channel called the 956 Studio. Hey, today's video, we're going to be showing you how to hook up a 30 amp RV receptacle or plug, whatever you'd like to call it. Some people, old timers call it, let's put a plug in, but it is a receptacle, basically. And we're going to show you some of the options you might have and how to distinguish between what wires you're going to be needing to use for that specific application. So stick around, let me show you how it's done. Now let's get this thing rolling. That I must say at this point in the video is that if you're working with this yourself and you're not a trained electrician, certified electrician, or familiar with electricity, do not attempt to work on this without some guidance. This is just an instructional video, and if you don't feel comfortable working with it, call a certified electrician to do your job and pay whatever it costs. Your life is not worth the $50, $75, $100, $150. It's just not worth it, folks. But this video is instructional, pretty simple, pretty basic, and it should be something that you should be able to accomplish in a matter of a few minutes. Now, to determine which wire you probably need for this 30 amp circuit here, you surely could not use the 14-2. It's just not heavy enough. So don't gamble with that. Possibility of causing yourself a fire or some electrical issues. Next up will be the 12-2. Although it's a little heavier and will carry more current, and it would not be the go-to wire that I would choose, I would highly recommend going up to 8 gauge. Now check with your manufacturer specs on your specific application or your travel trailer, whatever it is you're putting this RV plug in, to make sure you are choosing the slick or correct wire. Now, I personally would choose this, but I would charge I don't need a four wire setup. All I need is three. I need a black or white, and a ground. I do not need the red wire, so you can buy accordingly. Just say this does not exist in this video, but I'd be using this size of wire to actually wire up the RV receptacle plug. Now that we've got that covered and discussed, let's look at the plug. The plugs are also pretty simple. Now, if you look at the back of these plugs, they will normally be, and this is a Leviton, normally be marked. I know you may not see it in the video, but it says white right here. And of course, this would be your black wire. On the bottom would be your ground, and how you know it's also ground is by the grounding strap. In this situation here, if you're using a metal box, you could run the ground wire from here and jump it from here back to your metal box, if you're using a metal box, such as this one right here. You'll have an actual secure ground at that point in time. Some of the old plugs do not have this here, so that would not apply with this application on this plug. Now let's flip it around, and I have marked it so that it's easier for you to see in the setting that we're in right now. You got your two wires here. You got your black wire here, your white wire here, and your ground wire there. And it does state here, recreational vehicle use only. So white is your neutral wire. Black is your live wire. So this wire here will be carrying your current of 110 volts. Now we do say it's 125 volt plug, but it's 30 amps, 125 volt. So that's not even close to comparing to 50 amps. So don't try to wire this up to run 240 volts on 50 amp, because it's not suitable for that application. And of course, the bottom is your ground. Your ground wire would either be, in this situation, green or bare copper, which is what we got right there. Now let's wire this thing up so you know clearly what we're doing here. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to strip off some more of this wire. And you want to be pretty careful when you're cutting into this to make sure you do not slice into the conductors themselves or the wires. I have a little bit of arthritis here, so I have some problems sometimes closing pliers, but we'll get the job done. And you'll peel back any other stuff that you don't need. And just for the purpose of this video, we are going to cut out the wire that we're not going to use so it doesn't confuse you. We're going to cut out that red wire right there. Now then, go back in here and strip out the ends of these. Didn't Okay, we're at the point in the video where I want to show you a little tip that I also learned many years ago. If you look at the back of these receptacles or plugs, whatever you like to call them, there's what they call a wire strip gauge, and it's a piece that goes from here to here, and it's hard to read it, and you may not be able to see it in the video, but it says here, strip gauge or wire strip right here. And what they're referencing is this area from here to here is the area that needs to be cut off, cleaned up, the insulation needs to be removed. So there's an indicator or a gauge that shows you how much wire you need to take off of that in order to make you the perfect hook to go around these screws. So just a tip, guys, right there is your wire strip gauge. Cut it, make sure that it's just like you see there. And guys, I gotta give a handout or plug out to this Klein Tool Company. I have had these little pliers here for approximately 10 or 12 years, and look at them, they're all wore out. They still do an excellent job. So if you're in the market to buy any wire strippers or anything like that, I would highly suggest using Klein Tools. They're probably the number one in the industry as far as I'm concerned. Now that's my opinion. Okay, now we got these all clipped off on the ends. And don't clip off any more than necessary, because what happens is if you clip off too much, the wire gets bare and it actually goes to ground inside the box. If you're using a metal box, you may trip your breaker and possibly cause some electrical shock on your part. So do not take off any more of the wire than needed. Now I do have all these wires or these screws backed out. So we're going to start with the ground first. The ground is always what you see there, like a horseshoe style. You put your ground right in there. And it's going to go right inside there. I know you might have some difficulty seeing that, but right there. Once you have the screw backed out far enough, you see the wire just kind of falls right in place. And then you'll tighten that back down. And make sure you tighten it really, really good, and then give it a good tug to make sure that it doesn't come back out. Now, while we're on this subject right here of putting the wires in place, you're going to find out that these screws will accommodate two or three different types of screwdrivers. You can use a flat, which goes right there. It works not quite as well as the last screwdriver I'm going to show you. Then you can use a Phillips, which works very well as also, because it grips all four sections of it. My go-to is this one right here, a south wire. Now, see the top of it, it says SDQ2P4. And the reason I say this is my go-to screwdriver, let me get underneath it so you can see it. It's square on the end, and this usually works on your circuit breakers and GE breaker boxes, and maybe you have several others. But it fits right down inside there, and it really gets a good grip on it, and it makes it so easy to tighten up. So that is my go-to right there, my south wire. Now I will post some links down in the bottom description where you can find some of these things, these tools that are similar to this, and I will also post some links down in the description where you can get your wire strip compliant. So hit the more button down below and it'll take you to those links. Okay, as we discussed earlier, this is the black. And it will also be marked white on this side, and black will be on this side. So let's go ahead and bend this up here. Let's back the screw out some more. Let's slide that in there. Now make sure that you also do not slide it any further in to where the insulation gets underneath the screw. If you do that, it will not have a good contact, and you may not be getting a proper amount of voltage in or out of it. So push it in there as far as necessary and the correct way, and tighten it down, okay, just like so, and give it a tug. Now then, last but not least, we're getting over to the black one. Let's see if I got it backed out. I do, and I've got it pushed in there perfectly. We'll take our tool here and tighten this down and give that a good yank. And there you go, folks. You've accomplished it. You've got that thing wired up. Now, this is 125 volt. Do not get this confused with 240 volt. If you're running 240 volt, you're going to have a black, a red, and you're going to have a neutral, and you're going to have a black, a red, a neutral, and you're going to have a ground. Now, that's going to be a four-wire setup. Now, in the old days, or prior to this video, years ago, they only had three wires. So that's a different video. We'll put that out there to help you understand that circuit a little bit better. But we got this wired up, and something I must say, now I'm going to take these back out, and I want to show you what might happen if you don't do the stuff the proper way in the box that may cause you some issues of throwing your circuit breaker. Now, I should have really put this through the box, but it was easier to shoot the video just like I did now. So what I'm going to do is, let's say we was putting it in this one here. That would be a really nice box to use. You don't have to knock these out if you don't want to. You can get them where they're plugged up. And this is an external mount box that mounts on the outside of the wall. Now, if you're using something that goes inside the wall behind the sheetrock, that's a totally different story. We'll cover that in another video. But you'll put your screws in here and here, and then your cover plate will go over that. Pretty safe in a plastic box because it doesn't transfer electricity or conduct. But let's say we're using a metal box. There's your knockouts. There, and those two. But let's say the wire is coming in through one of the knockouts, and you've got it all tied in place over here. And you know, you got a wire that's loose or anything like that, or shorted out and it hits this box. It doesn't throw a breaker, but it's conducting enough electricity. If you were to grab this and it's still conducting electricity, chances are electrical shock immediately. So grounding is very important in a lot of these boxes. On this plug, it's not too critical because you have a ground wire here going out, and a ground wire is going to be grounded back in the breaker box. So hopefully that would not be an issue. But you know, each plug, each receptacle is totally different, and respect electricity because it is super, super powerful, and you don't get but one shot at it. Once it gets you, it's got you. Something I must say, we ask that if you've gotten any information out of this video that's been helpful, that you've learned anything from it. We're a small channel. We ask that you hit the thumbs up, like, and subscribe. Play this video. Pass it out to your friends, relatives, somebody else that might need it. This just might help them save some money and get the job done properly by themselves. As we all know, we're in a new generation of people here. And this new generation just doesn't seem to want to learn much about these kind of things. And they think that they can sit on the couch and play Xbox games and everything is free in the world. Well, this video hopefully will save the ones of you that are interested in it a few dollars, and I hope that it helps you. Again, thumbs up, like, subscribe. We hope to see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.